But I was in Mecca, and they told me that there's an imam in Cape Town, and he says that homosexuality is permissible. So I said, impossible. He said, no, there's that. So I said, fine, if he wants to discuss it, I can discuss it.
I myself is homosexual. I know what I've been through. I got married because I thought that was going to change me. I fasted 80 days every year besides Ramadan, asking Allah to help me to just get rid of these things. They haven't moved. I have started with this thing from the age of 12. At the age of 5, I recognized that I was different from other boys. We feel that it's not a choice that we make, that somehow the Quran should be speaking about us as well, that we also have rights as human beings.
What do you say? Is homosexuality permissible in Islam? Is that what you're promoting? We will consider you a murtad, an apostate, and out of the fold of Islam, you would not be buried in a Muslim graveyard. No Muslim person would ever read your Salatul Janazah.
We have looked at all these verses from the Quran, and obviously we have a different interpretation of what has happened then.
No person can make interpretation to suit his desires or her desires when you have clear-cut verses. And when Lut alayhi salatu wasalam, peace be upon him, when he addressed his people and told them, Ata'atun al-fahisha, do you commit and bring that obscene and lewd action where a male fulfills his desire with a male?
We cannot just take the verses from the Quran and use it as a blanket condemnation for homosexuality. When foreigners and guests came into the city of Sodom and Gomorrah, these men were rushing to molest them. As the Quran says, it was an abomination that they've been doing for a long time. So it was a male-to-male rape. So Allah doesn't refer to the homosexual relationship here, but He's referring to a homosexual act, which was the molestation, which taking the rights of another person away from him.
So you want to leave the direct text and accept some human being's opinion to play with semantics and say that this is, you know, molestation. I mean, you are just playing with words. Homosexuality is a crime not only in Islam, in every divine religion, and is punishable in Islam by death. And we say if it was an Islamic state, then you would be faced the capital punishment. The only difference among the jurists is how that person should be killed. That's the only difference. And I gave you the hadith of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the saying, فَقْتُلُوا الْفَاعِلُ وَالْمَفْعُولُ بِهِ.